When we studied the pathophysiology of schizophrenia in the last class, what we have seen? Dopamine, main chemical, serotonin. Here we'll see noradrenaline also. So dopamine, what we have seen, dopamine is a happiest chemical. So when dopamine causes, or when dopamine releases, it causes excessive happiness. So when dopamine releases, it causes excessive happiness. In schizophrenia condition, what we have seen, there are elevated levels of dopamine. So when there is elevated levels of dopamine, it is causing schizophrenia. It means patient is overexcited. But in depression, we know what is depression means, low mood disorders. So usually patients will be very in bad mood or in sad mood. So it means the dopamine is getting depleted. What? Dopamine is getting depleted in depression. So in depression, there is a dopamine theory or hypothesis that there is decreased levels of dopamine in depression. Same way with the serotonin. What does serotonin? I have told you in the last class, serotonin is a happy chemical. Serotonin is a happy chemical. When the serotonin or is a happy chemical is in elevated conditions or in elevated situations, then the patient experiences this schizophrenia. Or as we already, in depression there is low mood and sad mood changes, there are decreased levels of serotonin in depression. Same with noradrenaline. Noradrenaline is a chemical or a neurotransmitter or a hormone which increases your activities. So in English there is a phase called adrenaline rush. Did you hear any time, guys? Adrenaline rush. When you are in extreme fear or when you are in extreme sensual pleasures, there will be a condition or a phase called adrenaline rush. Means when adrenaline is rushed inside the body, increased blood pressure will be there, increased heart rate, increased pulse rate, and increased activity of the brain, all leads to like activity. Physical, all leads to increased physical activity. In depression condition, there are decreased levels of noradrenaline also. So you have understood the terms and principal actions of these chemicals, right? Now we'll see in the detail. In any psychological conditions or disorders, there will not be actual hypothesis or pathophysiology for that disorder. There will be few hypotheses or few theory states, this may be the reason. So one hypothesis is dopamine hypothesis, same like schizophrenia. As we have seen the causes or risk factors of depression, right? Like any family history, traumatic event, physical or sexual abuse, or chronic illness, etc. Due to all that alterations, or due to all that causes, a person in CNS neural circuits get constricted. This leads to dopaminergic decreased production, or this leads to dopaminergic hypoproduction, or dopamine easy reuptake. What is mean by reuptake? For example, dopamine is released by dopa decarboxylase. this DOPA, which is converted into final product, easily gets recycled or reuptaked for next synthesis of dopamine. Understood, guys? Dopamine, without showing its function, easily getting reuptake for the synthesis of another function. Now see, due to any factors in CNS, neural circuits get constricted or contracted, which leads to the dopaminergic low production or dopaminergic hypoproduction or dopamine easy reuptake. This all leads to less dopamine in CNS. When there is less dopamine in CNS, it is causing depression. This is the one hypothesis stating the pathophysiology of depression. That's why we give this dopamine conversion occurs due to mono amino oxidase enzyme. DOPA or dopamine converts into final product, and this reuptake is done with this mono amino oxidase enzyme. So that's why when this monoamino oxidase enzyme is more, so what happens, guys? Concentrate here. In CNS, if neural circuits gets constricted or contracted, then there is dopaminergic lesser production and dopaminergic easy reuptake. This dopamine easy reuptake will be promoted by monoamino oxidase. When it is promoted by monoamino oxidase, there is less dopamine in CNS, leading to depression. So if we restrict the entry or use of monoamino oxidase, what it will be there? Just concentrate. When there is less monoamino oxidase, when there is monoamino oxidase, there is no dopamine. No dopamine means depression, right? Clear, guys? When there is monoamino oxidase, then there is no dopamine, then leading to depression. But when we decrease this monoamino oxidase, what does it happen? Then there is dopamine. It leads to no depression or antidepressant action. That's why we give the drugs called monoamino oxidase inhibitors. When we give the drugs to inhibit this monoamino oxidase, then there will be dopamine will be there. There is no conversion of dopamine. This is that just in the pathophysiological approach, I am telling the pharmacological category, but later we will see this in the classification also. So don't get confused. So this is about one hypothesis of depression, that is dopamine hypothesis. As we all know, dopamine causes happiness and excitation, as it is a neurotransmitter. Dopamine chemical neurotransmitter nature is to provide happiness and excitation. When in CNS, when neural circuits gets constricted due to any of the reasons, dopaminergic decreased production will take place, or dopaminergic hyperproduction takes place, or dopamine easy reuptake happens due to monoamino oxidase. So this all leads to less dopamine in the CNS, which is leading to depression. That's why we'll give the drugs called monoamino oxidase inhibitors.